Warriors continue. They're 9-2, and they beat the Mavericks. But it was about Klay Thompson. Klay Thompson came back. They gave fans the Klay Thompson hat. He's a legendary boater. He played well. They had a video. It was wonderful. It was sweet. Romanticizing. Very special night. And now everybody can go their own way. Warriors are better without him. Dallas is better with him. That's called sports. Trees do not grow to the sky. You have to factor in age, contract, and injuries with older players. Get out of this whole Warriors owed him anything. Have you ever run a business? That's not how it works. What can you deliver now if you're a top executive or a top athlete? I'm not paying you for 7 years ago. They treated him well. They paid him $260 million. It's a world-class organization. You don't give out lifetime achievement contracts. They do that in Hollywood, and it's usually cringy. Nobody was disrespected here. Again, there's salary caps. It's grown-ups. I think what happened, and Klay was getting very streaky. He was sort of becoming a ghost in the playoffs. And defensively, he used to be a great player, but there's so many injuries, he became a little bit of a liability. Sometimes not a little bit. And the Warriors said, listen, we're going to offer you a role, reduce salary, it'll be a role. And he didn't like the offer. And I have no problem with the Warriors offering him a reduced role and reduced salary. And I have no problem with Klay Thompson saying, no, Mav's going to pay me more and need me more. That's called sports. San Antonio, Tony Parker, Manu Ginobili, accepted roles as they age. And here comes Kawhi Leonard, and we're getting younger, and we have to. And they accepted their roles. Klay Thompson's like, I'm not going to. I've been at the top of the mountain here. I was the number one, two guard in the league for a long time. We got the name Splash Brothers, probably the best backcourt ever, certainly in the Jerry West, Gale Goodrich class. It was a great, and he deserved all of it. And they paid him, and they treated him well. But he didn't like his role. And I think what is this, I've seen this with guys. A lot of us guys collected baseball cards as kids, you know, and then we got girlfriends and grew up. But a lot of you guys never, ever lose that childhood devotion to your athletes. They move on. It's a business. Why is everybody in the NBA chasing the Boston Celtics? They moved off KG and Paul Pierce. They got a bunch of picks, and those picks became Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. That's why everybody's chasing them, because they hit on two picks, and then they find Derek White, go get him somewhere, and Porzingis, and make moves, and now they're easily the best team in the NBA. So it's 2024. Sports is an incredibly cold business, and that's okay. Everybody knows it is. Nobody's losing sleep. That doesn't mean last night wasn't cool, wasn't special. I felt the Warriors could have treated this a lot of different ways, but they wanted to make sure. Look at the crowd. It's great. They all got Klay hats. Klay meant a lot to these people. But you know what means more now? The future. And signing him to a long deal, a lifetime achievement contract, that paralyzes franchises for a decade. And you know what? I think Klay is going to be great in Dallas. They need a catch-and-shoot guy. They got Kyrie and Luka. Those guys always have the ball in their hands. Klay is perfect in Dallas. He's a catch-and-shoot guy. You can give him the ball with 3 seconds on the clock. Boom, hits a three. But he was appreciative. I think it meant a lot to the Warriors. It meant a ton to the fans. And here was a really nice guy after.
It was a really cool experience. I appreciate the fans very much. The captain's hat ended up being a great touch. So I'm such a passionate boater, and saw a lot of familiar faces in the crowd. That was a warm-hearted feeling. So it was really cool to see the fans, their gratitude towards myself, and something I will never take for granted.
Wonderful guy, wonderful moment. Terrific night, touched a lot of people, and this is a nice bow on the present. Everybody is better served. Frankly, Klay Thompson is better served not being a Warrior. He'll be a much more important player on a Warrior team that is basically now Steph, Draymond, Wiggins, and kids. It is a deep roster. They play a ton of guys. They play a bunch of minutes. They're long. They're athletic. Steph, still elite. Draymond at what he does, still elite. Wiggins, they're stuck with a contract. They just didn't want to be stuck with two contracts. Great night. Way to go, Clay. All right, so the Bears moved off yesterday, offensive coordinator Shane Waldron. So now the stories trickle out. Bears players went to the head coach and the GM, Matt Eberflus, Ryan Poles, and they said, get Shane out of here. Some of the older players, veteran players, wanted to bench Caleb Williams for his backup. Benching Caleb Williams is not the solution. Fixing him is the solution. Veteran pro athletes don't have any patience because they see the end of their careers coming and the end of their contracts. It's why players should play, not coach and GM. Look at LeBron's teams when he leaves. They're a mess. Teams let him GM. Older players have agendas. Their contracts, their stats, and their careers. I mean, have you seen what the New York Jets look like? They handed too much power to Aaron Rodgers, and what was Aaron doing as an older player? Seeking familiarity and seeking comfort. He didn't care about the Jets' plans. He cared about Aaron Rodgers. And, you know, if I was older broadcaster, of course I'm still so young now, maybe that's what I'd care about. But, I mean, you can't lose patience on this. First of all, young quarterbacks is a roller coaster ride. Let's just take a look at Bo Nix. Remember how bad Bo Nix was in the first two starts? You guys were all bailing on him. Colin, you don't know what you're talking about. This guy's no good. You're just listening to Sean Payton. Sean Payton, you text your buddies. I'm like, no, he's a rookie on a pretty average roster with one or maybe two really good offensive linemen. Bo Nix, first 2 weeks, no touchdowns, four turnovers, and a 47 passer rating. Should you bench him? No. Shane Waldron's not an elite coach. Bears are not an elite organization. Caleb Williams is a rookie. This was going to be bumpy. I'll give you a great example. We love C.J. Stroud. C.J. Stroud last year had a three-game stretch. C.J. Stroud. Y'all love him. I do. Three-game stretch. 57% completion rate. You remember that? And by the way, he's had a couple stinkers this year. And that's the guy we love. With a great left tackle. With great weapons. Love his coach. Love his coordinator. I mean, we love everything he's around. He had a month last year, no good. And so Caleb's got 8 games left, and the Bears are 4-5. And I went on this show, we got the audio somewhere, and I predicted they'd be, I kept asking, what if they're a 7-win team, but you feel better about Caleb than Justin Fields? And my guess, if you look at their schedule, they're going to be a 7-win team. There's some wins in there, but they're going to be tough. Green Bay at home. Minnesota at home, they need to get at least one win there. But at Detroit, at San Francisco, at Minnesota, that could be a three-game skid. They get Detroit and Seattle at home, go to Green Bay. I think they got about 3 more wins in them. And that's about where they should be. I mean, nobody thought, none of you who are Bears fans, or not Bears fans, you didn't think Eberflus and Shane Waldron were the Andy Reid and Spags of the next generation. Now, Washington, in my opinion, did it the right way. They cleaned house. They said, we're going to get this young quarterback, Jaden Daniels, new coach, new coordinator, new owner, new GM. Everything was new. We're all in the same timeline. Chicago made a choice. You and I knew probably wasn't going to work. Eberflus was on the hot seat week one. In preseason, we were already trying to kind of pick apart what he was. So they decided, because the Bears are cheap and don't have great vision, especially on the offensive side of the ball, let's just keep everybody. Yeah, we'll just change the coordinator. Same president, same owner, same coach, same Washington did the opposite. It's been a flying success. Bears, we all know this isn't going to work. We all knew it at the time. And you also have Eberflus is just coaching to save his job. Caleb's just trying to get better. So they have different visions right now. Eberflus, urgency. Caleb, patience. Trying to get better every week, every pass, every series. So this is take a deep breath time. The solution is not listening. Thankfully, the Bears didn't. It's not listening to older players. They're loyal to their contracts. They're loyal to their careers. Aaron to the New York Jets is a great example. He sought comfort. He sought familiarity. He didn't care about the Jets' long-term plans. You could screw this kid up if you sit him. Long, long runway here. I mean, we just moved the jet. It's doing a It's doing a U-turn right now. It's just trying to get on the runway. It's not even on the runway yet.